heroes, mentors, those we look up to. We've got more for you today, such as Snuffleupagus with a Saw from Weaponry Street. Or Alka Octopus from the OWCA. He's an alien on soda can. It's our job to analyze their weapons, armor, and skills to see who would win in a fight. All right, the opponents are set. Ever since the Ice Age, one species has existed. But what if I told you there was one still remaining animal from that species? Who is it? Dun-dun. Snuffleupagus with a Saw. Wait, you mean the dinosaurs? No, not the dinosaurs. The woolly mammoth. Woolly mammoth is a species that has been around since the dawn of time. In fact, they may look like an elephant, but they're much more fluffy and cuddly. But not Snuffleupagus with a Saw. Yep. He's a member of Weaponry Street. He's not supposed to be cute and cuddly. Well, he isn't. He uses his saw to his full advantage. In fact, he's seen to be the second strongest member of Weaponry Street. Who's the first? Animal with a baseball bat. Snuffleupagus with a Saw has even been seen to challenge villains such as General Sergeant, Fireman, and even the Sand Boa at times. Yeah, but no matter which fight he's in, he always wins. Snuffleupagus with a Saw is probably the most underrated member of Weaponry Street, period. He's seen to saw the whole house down and cut things down one at a time. In fact, he has a blade suit just like Grover with a chainsaw. So wait, he has a blade suit too? Yes, his blade suit covers him entirely in armor made of spiky saw blades and saw metal. In fact, when Snuffleupagus with a Saw's abilities to be released in the suit formed by the saw gods, Snuffleupagus with a Saw can cut down anything that stands in his way. He's practically the most indestructible being in Weaponry Street. Even an animal with a baseball bat doesn't have a suit like that. No. But Snuffleupagus with a Saw has even been seen to challenge Animal with a Baseball Bat over who's the most powerful in one episode of the 1980s cartoons. Snuffleupagus with a Saw is probably the most powerful Weaponry Street character if we're discluding Animal with a Baseball Bat. The only reason Animal with a Baseball Bat is more powerful is when he uses his outer space abilities. Snuffleupagus with a Saw has also been seen scaring off an entire army of military soldiers and scaring them off in less than a second. The second you hear that cry, does it sound like an elephant? You're running. Snuffleupagus with a Saw is not your average woolly mammoth. In fact, he uses his saw to cut up anything, just like the Grover with the chainsaw guy does. But make no mistake, he's still a very friendly woolly mammoth, especially down at Weaponry Street along with the rest of the Muppets. But when they get angry, they charge. Just a plain factor of the way Weaponry Street works. Actually, no, he has never been extinct. In fact, he's the last remaining of his kind. Snuffleupagus with a Saw is the last woolly mammoth alive, and he lives in Weaponry Street. He uses his saw to defeat villains such as General Sergeant Fireman and the Sand Boa. He even was seen cutting the Sand Boa in half, and the Sand Boa almost didn't regenerate. But somehow it did, because, you know, sand, it lives in the desert, yes. But after Snuffleupagus with a Saw defeated him, the Sand Boa kept coming back. It's not about the agility, it's about how Snuffleupagus with a Saw is practically undefeatable. In fact, his suit of armor is very powerful. And what else is powerful about it is he can activate his tusks to have little spikes on each tusk that can go round and round, similar to a chainsaw. And his eyes glow fully yellow, so he looks more like an elephant because he'd be silver. Yes, he does. Snuffleupagus with a Saw is also, if not the most powerful character in Weaponry Street. He was originally created by a scientist and brought back to life from the Ice Age by a scientist by the name of Mr. Ezekiel. But after Mr. Ezekiel's experiment failed massively, he became known as Snuffleupagus with a Saw. And after being cursed with a weapon by General Sergeant, ran straight to Weaponry Street. So he knows what he's doing. He'll know how to fight. He's got the spikes. He's got the saw. He is Snuffleupagus with a Saw. He lives in the ocean. He has arms of eight. He is Alka Octopus. Yes, Alka Octopus has lived in the ocean for a long time. And has defeated villains such as Badlick Chinzy and the Little Rascals and even Emperor Valestine. That's a lot to take on for a little octopus. He's not little. He's very strong and pretty big, too. In fact, the octopus has got tentacles that can stick onto anything just with the suction cups. Eight tentacles, eight arms, with about 34 to 36 suction cups each. In fact, another thing he can do is shoot out ink when nervous. And the ink actually helps in combat because the ink distracts his opponent from swimming towards him. In fact, another thing I want to mention about Alka Octopus is the fact that his suction cups have 34, 36 tentacles, which is basically like could tear the paint off of any surface or whatever substance is on it or it's made out of. Another thing about Alka Octopus is the fact that he is able to absorb anything. He's very durable. He's been able to withstand a lot of damage in the past. In fact, Balachenzi even left a hole in his back, and he still survived. That's nearly impossible. Not impossible when you're talking about Alka Octopus. Alka Octopus also has excellent hearing. He can hear up to 300 miles away. Oh, but when he uses both of his ears, he can hear up to 4,000 miles away. And Alka Octopus can hear anything coming from him from any direction in the ocean. So let's look at it this way. He also has excellent seeing. Alka Octopus can see from over 10 billion miles away and know what's coming in an instant. Also, Alka Octopus doesn't have a mouth. And how does he talk? He talks through his eyes. How does he talk through his eyes? Very simple. He just blinks to talk. Alka Octopus is strong. It's Courtney.